tick-tock, hickory dickory dock. Ooh, time to beat the clock. Time for fun has now begun. Let's all play beat the clock.
Beat the Clock is brought to you by Sylvania. For half a century, a quality name in incandescent bulbs, fluorescent tubes and fixtures, photo lamps, radio and television sets, radio and television tubes and electronic devices. Yes, for homes, offices, schools and factories, Sylvania.
Let's all play Beat the Clock.
Now, here is America's number one clock watcher, Bud Collyer.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, and welcome once again to Beat the Clock, the show where you have the time of your life playing against time for big-time prizes. We have a very pleasant and fairly common occurrence these days of re-meeting some people from whom time runs out, and we have to meet them all over again the next week. Mr. and Mrs. Harold McCabe of the Bronx, New York. Let's give them a welcome, shall we? You are a lieutenant in the fire department.
That's right.
New York City Fire Department?
Yes.
Where's your particular precinct, or whatever they call it?
22 truck, 97th Street and Amsterdam Avenue.
97th and Amsterdam?
Right.
Not too far from where I used to watch the one at 113th and Amsterdam. Do you remember that one up
there?
Right. Yeah, when I was a kid. It was, of course, just a few years ago.
That's right.
You've been married 17 years. You have four children. We met some of them last week, as I recall. You had gone through the $100 clock and were trying for the $200 when time ran out. And, of course, you saw the new bonus last week. We started a brand new one. It wasn't done last week. Tonight it's worth $200. Whenever the bell rings, whoever the people are out here at that time, can be you or anybody else, get a try at the new bonus for $200. Also, we have for you, Ms. McCabe, one of these nice little Roxanne Hostess apron patterns from Sylvania.
Thank you.
Take that along with you, if you will, please. You can put it down there until afterward. So right now, let's see. We're going to pick up with the gun ball catch. Remember, we had the ping pong balls and the guns that shot them, and you had to catch them. Now, last week, as I recall, sir, we put you in a mask, kind of protect your face against those ping pong balls, and you said, can I work without it? Now, which way would you rather do it?
Without it.
Without it. You don't want the protection
without
of that.
It, yeah.
Those big ping pong balls. Come on over here with me then on the $200 clock, and I'll explain all over again to those who didn't see it last week. Mrs. McCabe, you stand behind that line there. Mr. McCabe is going over behind that line over there. And as you recall, you shoot these guns here. I'll have to get around here so we can show everybody what they are. They're loaded with ping pong balls. And as you recall, you sort of pump them like that, and the ping pong balls come right out like that. Almost nailed the cameraman. So you keep on. We'll keep reloading and giving them to you as fast as you need them. You remain anywhere. If you come up this way a little, Mr. McCabe, you'll be a little closer, too. Right in there, that area there. If you get out there, they'll have to go off stage. Take a look at the clock again and see how many seconds you have. You have the full amount all over again. 55 seconds. What are you waving at her for?
I wanted to bring her nozzle down.
Oh, bring your nozzle down a little bit. That's the idea. All right, are you ready? Go. There's one he's got. Pump it hard. Give her another one. That's it. Ready? Go. That's it. Hey! What? There he goes. He's got the two he needs. Good for you. Fine. All right. All right, you did it. Fine. Hurry, that shows you when you have a chance to go off and practice these things, they go off fairly simply, don't they? Yeah. Well, now, of course, Mr. McCabe, you can't help in any way. This is Mrs. McCabe's moment to do it for the family. And if you'll step up there just a minute and get you all set there, because, you know, we're going to move up to the jackpot clock. And you look kind of pretty up there anyway.
Thank you.
Now, before we get you nervous about that, has anyone seen Roxanne? McCabe is going to try our jackpot clock. And, of course, you know you don't turn around till I tell you to. But in back of you now is our jackpot board with all the words of a famous saying or quotation. They're all mixed up, however. Now, you've got to try to identify what the saying is and then move those words around until they spell it out correctly in 20 seconds from the time I say go. Now, don't look till I tell you to. Open the curtain. Oh, wait just a minute. One fell down. I'll have to go get it here. Turn around and take a look. Go. It's not quite right. You're not quite right. You had it right before. All right, stop. That's it. Stop the clock. Good, good. Stop the clock. You did it. As the twig is bent, the tree's inclined. Good for you. Congratulations. Good.
You see, what threw you, what deceived you for a minute there is that the apostrophe S is on with the trees, you see. As the twig is bent, the trees incline. That's the way it is. And you did it. By golly, you went all the way through. You beat our jackpot clock, so let's see what you've won. Just take a look over here.
It's the 1954 Sylvania Stratford with a 21-inch screen and the great new photopower chassis for photographically clear pictures in even the most distant reception areas. And of course, the Stratford has halo light for the greatest eye comfort in all television. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. McCabe. You have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
All right, congratulations. Well, Roxanne, whom do we have now?
Bud, I'd like you to meet out Mr. and Mrs. George Smith from, I don't know how to
Gil
say that,
Smith.
Valdosta? Valdosta?
Gilbert
Smith.
Oh, I like G. That's a G. That should
G.
be.
I
that's
thought it
right.
was George.
No.
Oh.
Mr. and Mrs. Gil Smith of Valdosta, Georgia, is
Georgia?
That right? Or Valdosta, which?
Valdosta.
Valdosta, we got it. Georgia, welcome for the Smiths here. Nice to have you. Hello, Mr. Smith. How are you? Since we couldn't have had any trouble with the last name, we had to pick out some other part of it to have trouble with, didn't we? What do you do, Mr. Smith?
I'm an oil burner mechanic.
Do you have your own place of business here?
No, no.
You work for a concern?
Paragon Oil Company.
In Valdosta?
In Brooklyn. I'm living in Brooklyn.
Oh, you're living there now? I see. How long have you folks been married?
6 years.
What about children?
Two
children. Two little girls. How old are they?
4 and 5.
Oh, my, I expect they'd like a Roxanne doll, wouldn't they?
Yeah.
Roxanne, you got one of those back there? Bring it out. Show it to the Smiths, will you?
Oh,
there she is. She's got a little camera on her here that clicks, too, you see, and flashes on and off. And we'll have one backstage for each of them right after the show. Okay, thank you very much, Roxanne. All right, Mr. and Ms. Smith, let's see what we have for you now. I have a little problem in... can you work all right without your glasses, both of you? All right, would you take them off then and put them down here? I think they'll be safe. And then if you both come over here with me, you take your hat off, too. Oh, opponent! You get my opponent! Come on over here with me, sir. Oh, you know what? I didn't take a count of 2.5. Come on over here, if you will, please, with the bonus girl. Set it up where it belongs. That's it. You come out over here with me, Mr. Smith. Sir, are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Right-handed. Well, then you'll stand on this side of this table, and what you do is this. You take this child's chair like this, and you see the legs we have taped? Those are the ones that you have to operate with. You place this on top of your head like this. You pick these saucers up one at a time, and you balance them on these back legs, right back in there, you see, until you get one on each of the legs. Like that. One on each of those two legs that are striped, held there without dropping. We'll stop the clock, and you'll beat the clock. Now, you take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have, sir. 40 seconds. Stand where I was. Get the chair on top of your head. Get a saucer in your hand. Are you ready? Go. Now, you can change hands if you want to. You can do anything you want. Use the same hand or change hands. Do any way you want. Don't let that worry you. Got the second one. Now, go after that first one again. Watch. Oh. Still got 15 seconds. You can do it. You can do it. Don't let that worry you. You can do it. Oh, golly, I'm sorry, sir, but a good... Well, good. Good try. Now, if you both come out over here... Step right on now if you leave your glasses there, because they will get in your way for this one. Mrs. Smith, I think you stay back here. Mr. Smith, you come over on this side for this. And we have a couple of football helmets for you. Want me to hold those for you, Betty?
Okay.
Put those football helmets on, if you will. Put them on as comfortably and easily as you can. Now, you can hold those on by your hands if you want to. What you have to do is simply this. If you stand apart just a little further, I want to show you that here is a little curtain ring, you see? Slides up and down. Now, here is some balloons, and we are going to put these balloons on. There'll be three of them in all. What you have to do is break three balloons. You got the idea? Have you got an extra one over there? Yes, we have. We'll hook these on here like this, you see? And without touching them with your hands, without blowing them or anything else, you've got to work them somehow down this string all the way over to here, where your husband will be waiting with a cork in his mouth that has a needle in the end. You have to break three balloons, and we'll stop the clock, and you'll beat the clock. Got the idea? Can't touch it with your hands, kick them with your feet, or blow them, or anything like that, in any way, shape, or form. All right, take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 55 seconds. You don't understand?
No.
All you have to do, for example, that's right, you have to make it slide to him. For example, if this is tight, you see, and he's lower than you are, this will slide down, won't it?
Oh, yeah.
So you better stay kind of high for this. Got the idea? Are you ready? Go! Here, hold the clock. Here comes the second one. Okay, Betty, slide it up there and let her go. Are you ready? Go! There you go. All right, I'll get the ring up again for you, Madeline. Here's the third one. Go ahead. All right, pull it up high. You ready? Go! Over here with me. Oh, I tell you, it was the funniest thing. You know, I never saw your wife say yes so much. You just sitting there like this, you know, it's going like that. I don't know if you could hear him, but he was down there with a cork in his mouth saying, don't shake it, don't shake it. Well, you got it anyway. You got the three balloons, and that got you through, of course. Which clock was that? That was the $100 clock. I'm getting so confused out here, I don't know which clock you're on even. So we move on now to the $200 clock, which is coming right at you right away. Incidentally, do you ever play the money wheels at the fairs and things like that? Did you ever play them?
Never did.
Well, we have a special money wheel we want you two to play. If you both come over here with me, I'll show you how this works. Bring out our game wheel there, will you? That's the idea. Our wheel of fortune, so to speak. If you'll step up there, sir, and have a seat on that stool with your back to the wall. Girls have a shower cap for you, just to keep your long hair out of your eyes. That's all that's for. Okay, Betty. Now, I want to show you this money wheel up here. Mrs. Smith, if you'll step up there and stand right about that end of the table there, you'll find a whole lot of paraphernalia down there, and you'll find something that matches everything on this wheel. Here's seltzer. There are bottles of seltzer over there. You see them? Right there. That's right. Here's chocolate milk. That's in this. You tip it. It comes out here. You press on that. You see? Here is Ready Whip. That's these. You know how these work, do you? You press on those little tips. That's right. And it says, let me see, pie. Pie. There are some nice pies. Well, what happens is this. Your husband is going to spin this wheel like that. See? Wherever that wheel stops, for example, it stops on pie. All you do is pick up a pie and throw it at his face. That's all. And if it stops on seltzer, you squirt him with a seltzer. If it stops on chocolate milk, you let him have the chocolate milk or the Ready Whip, as the case may be. And as soon as it stops, you'll notice that here is one that says beat the clock, and there's one that says beat the clock. If it stops on either one of those, we'll stop the clock, and you beat the clock, okay? All right, let's take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. 45 seconds from the time I say go. Are you ready? Go! Oh, you got to give a good spin. Good spin. That's the boy. I don't know where it's going to come to it. Oh, you just stopped before. Ready, Whip. Ready. Pie. Got a pie on that one. Chocolate milk. That's the one. Ready, Whip! Beat the clock! You did it! Come out and take a picture of this fine gentleman, and we'll have it with our Sylvania Super Flash Bulb with a blue dot for sure shot. The girls will get you all cleaned up, sir. You don't have to come back over here. Do you want to dry your hands or anything? Okay, good enough. Thank you very much, Madeline. And now you carry on for the family, Mrs. Smith, by stepping into the spotlight of our jackpot clock. Now, if you step right up on that far end of that platform, turn around and face the audience. Tell me first, did you enjoy that?
Yes.
I kind of thought you would. All right. Now, in back of you is our jackpot board, and on it are all of the words of another famous saying or quotation, and they're all mixed up and out of order. You've got to get them back in order in 20 seconds from the time I say go, so they spell out correctly the saying or quotation, okay? Now, don't turn around till I tell you to. Open the curtain. Turn around and take a look. Go. No, it's not right. It's not right. That's all I can tell you. It's not right. It's almost right. It's very close to right.
Well, all right, I'll give it to you on that. Many a true word is spoken and said. Okay. All right, that was a good one. I don't know how to do that. I assume you knew where that was going, so I'll give you the credit. Okay. So you two have beaten our jackpot clock, and let's see what you've won. Just take a look over here.
Again, Sylvania presents the Stratford, one of its great TV line 454, with such exclusive features as the photo power chassis for photographically clear pictures in all areas, and halo light, which surrounds this 21-inch screen for the most comfortable viewing you've ever experienced. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Smith. You, too, have just won Sylvania's jackpot prize.
Thank you. Good night. Roxanne, whom do we have now?
Bud, now I'd like you to meet Mr. and Mrs. Cooey Chung from Brooklyn, New York.
Well, a very warm welcome to the Chungs. How nice to have you here. How are you, sir?
You, Mr. Chung. Nice to have you. You mind standing on that side of your pretty wife? Never was a pretty girl in the picture. I like to have her next to me. I don't like the husband in between.
Tell me, how long have you folks been married?
A little over a year now, sir.
Where were you born, Cooey?
New York.
New York City. And how long have you been in the Army?
Oh, almost 3 years.
You plan to make a career of it?
No, I'm not.
What would you like to do in civilian life?
Well, I'm getting out soon and...
What sort of work are you doing in the Army? Recruiting?
I'm doing recruiting.
Uh-huh. And what would you like to do when you get out?
Well, I have a deal with some company cooked up and...
Got a deal cooked up there, boy, huh? Well, whatever it is, I wish you both all the happiness in the world. And you have been able to move along pretty much where he's been stationed, have you?
He's been stationed down at Whitehall Street. Hey, we haven't had to move anywhere.
Well, how wonderful. That's a real break. Do you have children?
Yes, we have one little boy.
What's his name?
Michael.
I got a Michael, too. How old is your Michael?
Michael is 2 months old.
You suppose he's watching tonight?
He'll be 3 months old Tuesday.
Oh, drat, we almost made a mistake, didn't we? Do you suppose he's watching?
He should be right there.
He should be right there. Well, you wave right into that camera there. Just...
Oh, Mike.
In case Michael, all of 3 months old, is watching, we hope he is. Mr. and Mrs. Chung, now, Mrs. Chung, on the $100 clock, you have to start operations here, so if you'll step over here with me, please. And stop here just long enough for me to show you that we have a ball hanging on a string, you see? Okay. Now, over here is a little tabouret. And this tabouret is so set that with this cup sitting here like that, if this ball is swung past the cup and comes back behind it like this, it will hit it and knock it off into the basket. Now, if you hit it going forward, it'll knock it the wrong way. So you must swing it past the cup and let it hit it on the way back in order to knock the cup in the basket. Want you to knock two cups into the basket in that way, and we'll stop the clock and you'll beat the clock. Got the idea?
Yes.
All right, now if you stand to do this, back of this black line all the time, you must remain back there with your toes on that black line. That's the idea. And take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. 55 seconds. You understand what you have to do?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Go. Don't throw it. You got the idea, that's it. Got to go in a little arc like that. Not quite so much. Too much of an arc. Ooh! There's one! There we go. Ready? Go! Ooh! The clock. The clock beat you, and that was an awful good try, but we have something for you anyway. We have one of these lovely Sylvania radios to take along with you.
Beautiful.
Thank you very much for being a real good contestant and an awfully good sport. Good night. Nice to have you here, little Sergeant. Good night. Roxanne, who are our next contestants?
First, but I'd like you to meet Marilyn and her little brother, Edward, and Mr. and Mrs. Robert Warner from Franklin Square, Long Island, New York.
Thank you very much, Roxanne. Hello, Mr. Warner. How are you, sir? Mrs. Warner, had a nice,
Hello.
Nice bonnet you have on. That's kind of a sassy one, isn't it, huh? Hello, young lady. Come on out here where your friends and neighbors can all see you. What's your name?
Marilyn.
How old are you, Marilyn?
11 and a half.
You go to school?
Mm-hmm.
What grade are you?
Seventh.
You like school?
Mm-hmm.
What do you like best?
Spelling.
You like spell, do you? No kidding. Well, that's right. What about your brother here? How old is he? Come on, son. What's your name?
Edward.
Come on, don't be so scared, boy. Everything's all right. Nobody's going to bite you. What grade are you in school?
Third.
Have you planned what you want to be when you grow up yet, son?
No.
Haven't you? What does your daddy do?
He's a greeting card salesman.
Would you like to be a greeting card salesman?
No.
Why not? Huh?
Because.
Because. All right. Daddy, we have a little something for each. Would you like a Roxanne doll? You would. Well, we not only have a Roxanne doll for you, but we have a camera for the young man here, which can use those wonderful Sylvania flashbulbs with a blue dot for sure shot. We'll have a packet of those flashbulbs for you, too, after the show, okay? All right, good enough. Now, Mr. and Ms. Warner, let's see what your problem here is on the $100 clock. And when Christmas time comes around, you know, as it's coming up pretty fast now, usually the papas get out the electric trains that belong to the sons, and they do the playing with them. So we're going to let you start off the whole season of papas playing with electric trains. Come on over here with me, Mr. Warner, if you will, please. Now, I want you to sit on this stool in this way. Don't actually get your feet up off the ground, but just perch on the stool because you'll get a better balance if your feet are on the ground. Got the idea? All right, you just perch on that there. Be kind of comfortable. That's it. Now, you have a fishing pole here for you. See, here it is, with a little hook on it. It's a very shallow hook. And we have over here some little imitation bags of coal, which we're going to hook on there like that. Now, over yonder is a Lionel electric train, see, with a wonderful whole Lionel outfit, as a matter of fact. And even a little tender back there. There are two Lionel coal cars. See them there? Right there. They're empty. Beg pardon?
Do I get to keep them?
No, you get something nicer if you do a little job for us. And that is, we're going to start the train running. As the train is running around the track, when I say go, you will start trying to release that bag in one of those coal cars. Drop it in the coal car, unhook the hook, and then we'll hook another one on, and you drop one in the other coal car. When each coal car has a bag of coal in it, we'll stop the clock, and you'll beat the clock. Got the idea? All right, let's take a look at the clock. See how many seconds you have. 55 seconds to do it. I'll get going here with the train. And are you ready? I'll tell you when. Go. You can hold it in two hands if you want it. Do whatever you want. You must stay on the stool. There's one. Get it unhooked now. Get it unhooked. All right, here comes another one. Have electric trains?
Yes.
You have electric trains. No fair. You've been practicing at home. I can see that. Well, in any event, that starts off the electric train season, and we're very grateful to the Lionel Company for giving us that set, that Lionel outfit that we had there. All right. Well, we move along now, of course, to the next clock, and Mom and Pop are doing fine. At least Pop is. Mom hasn't done anything yet, but maybe we'll put her to work in just a minute. Well, we're going to move the pair of you into this next one on the $200 clock, so will you both come over with me, Mr. and Ms. Warner? Now, over here, I have two cans of beer, and they're full cans. They're full cans of beer. Now, you notice that here are two little tabarets. They mark out this line that's between them, and that's the boundary line over which you, Mr. Warner, have got to walk. I'm going to place one beer can here. I'm going to place the other one there. And what you have to do to start this off, sir, is to get yourself balanced as best you can on these two beer cans. Then your wife, when you say to her, will pick up this one beer can, move it forward as you lift your foot off it, and then you will step to that beer can. Then she'll move the other one forward, and you step to the next beer can. You keep walking from beer can to beer can until you cross this line. Got the idea? And you must operate behind him at all times.
Behind
him at all times, okay? Let's take a look at the clock, see how many seconds you have. 45 seconds to do it. You tell me when you're ready. Are you ready? Go. Behind him. Okay. I'm telling you, he's a real well-balanced guy. All right, now, time is running short, so if you kids will all move over there with Dad, I'm going to let Mom have a crack at the jackpot clock. If you step up here on this platform at the far end, in back of you now, if you stand down there, sir, is our magnetic board with all the words of a famous saying or quotation all mixed up. Get them unmixed in 20 seconds. Got the idea? Now, don't look till I tell you to. Open the curtain. Turn around, take a look. Go. Oh, I'm
sorry you didn't beat the clock. The clock beat you. What it should have been is the easiest person to deceive is one's own self. The easiest person to deceive is one's own self. Have we got time to award the prize? Do we have time to show them what they've won? We don't have. Well, you'll have to just look next week then, if you will, because you've beaten our $200 clock, and the first thing we'll do next week is show you on television what it is that you've won. Thanks ever so much for being with us tonight. Good night, good luck, God bless you. Well, that's all we have time for, ladies and gentlemen, right now. This is Bud Collyer speaking for Sylvania, hoping that next time may be your time to beat the clock. Good night, everybody.
This has been a Mark Goodson-Todman production, produced in association with the CBS Television Network. Roxanne's gone by Nat Kaplan. Beat the Clock is brought to you by Sylvania.